A lot of rain along the Grand Strand. At last check, more than 5 inches of rain on the ground, and more rain is on the way. South Carolina's weatherman Jim Gandy is joining us tonight with a complete look at this storm. The 11 o'clock numbers are in, and the storm has weakened just a little bit.
Just slightly, but that's not unexpected. But be careful in thinking that it has really weakened that much. Keep in mind that the wind field is large.
Right.
So there's going to be a slow weakening, and that wind field is still a problem. Let me show you what's going on right now, the latest information. This was as of the 11 o'clock advisory. It was 15 miles west-northwest of Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Maximum sustained winds 65 miles per hour, moving to the west-southwest at 5 miles per hour. And this is the satellite picture right here, but I wanted to take you to the radar. And what you're looking at are the radars from Columbia, Charleston, and from Morehead City, because the Wilmington site has gone down. Yes, it is not necessarily raining right now in the Myrtle Beach area, but we've got a lot of rain that's been coming in through North Carolina, through the eastern part of our states, raining in Florence, and you can see raining in Manning, and we've got rain showers that are moving into the Sumter area. We've had a few light showers come through Columbia, but they have pretty much faded this evening. We're going to zoom out just a little bit, and you may see a little blip in the image here. Yep, right there. But I wanted to show you this band. See this band right here coming up through Morehead City, Jacksonville, that area. This has been persistent throughout the day, and it has been the source of a lot of rain, as has this band here that's been coming up through the Wilmington area. The center are right about right in here, and you can see more rain coming into North Carolina. It's just very slowly making its way into the Midlands. So it's been hurry up and wait. Let me show you. This is the radar estimate, and you can see near Jacksonville, North Carolina, 19.2 inches of rain. That's the Doppler estimate. And then, in fact, we may have some rain gauges there over 20. Over here near Wilmington, 13.8, and right here north of Myrtle Beach, over 5 inches of rain, with a lot more rain to come, because the forecast is for the Myrtle Beach area extending up toward Bennettsville to see easily maybe 15 inches of additional rain. And then for Florence, 10 plus. For Kershaw and for Sumter, you can expect somewhere between 7 to maybe as much as 10 inches of rain. But here in Columbia, we're still calling for only 3 to 5, and it may be less than that. And here's why. As the system comes on through, the bulk of the rain is going to be up here in the northern part of our state. Depending on how much drying takes place down here, the southern areas may not get as much rain. However, that doesn't mean that they're out of danger, because while they may not get much rain, they're probably going to get the water coming down the rivers next week. Here is the satellite picture once again with the wind field, which is still quite large across this storm, even though the maximum sustained wind is only 65 miles per hour. Here's the latest forecast from the National Hurricane Center, and notice moving very slowly overnight. Even by 8 o'clock tomorrow night, it's still making its way into the Midlands, but by then, it's got maximum sustained winds at 40 miles per hour. By Sunday morning, it's a tropical depression. And by about midday on Sunday, we expect this to move on up into North Carolina, and it'll be out of our state. Tropical storm warnings are in effect from Columbia all the way to the coast, from Charleston all the way up to Bennettsville. And here's what we're seeing right now. This is the sustained winds. Here in Columbia, we're seeing sustained at 14, but sustained at 32 in Sumter, 35 in Florence. But you're seeing winds gusting to 52 in Florence, 45 in the Sumter area, 29 here in Columbia, 36 in Orangeburg. And I just got a report, it's unofficial, from the Bishopville area. They were getting winds gusting to 58 miles per hour. Now that's in Lee County. So certainly Lee County, Sumter, Clarendon County, you can probably expect some more trees coming down.
Been on social media tonight, on Facebook and on Twitter, residents over in the Sumter and the Clarendon areas, in Lee County and in Kershaw County, they're all reporting widespread power outages tonight.